Thanks for stopping by. I'm Virgil, and this is 2-Minute Classroom. If this is your first time seeing my face, welcome. If you like my mustache, you should also like this video, and I'll take it as a personal compliment. Now, on to the topic at hand, the conservation of energy, and energy in general. So, the law of conservation of energy states that in a closed system, that is, a system isolated from its surroundings, the total energy of the system is conserved. Or, more loosely stated, energy cannot be created or destroyed, only transferred or transformed. This is also known as the first law of thermodynamics. So what do I mean by cannot be created or destroyed? If a bomb explodes, it's creating energy, right? And if a ball stops rolling, its energy must have been destroyed. Well, no, because energy cannot be created or destroyed, only transferred or transformed. Let's talk a little bit more about energy. The SI unit for energy is the joule, named after James Prescott Joule, and there are different forms of energy. I'm going to talk about 5. Number 1 is kinetic energy, and is probably the energy you're most familiar with. This is the energy of motion. So any object moving through space has kinetic energy. This includes a ball thrown through the air, a swimming fish, and even a shuttle, space shuttle, flying through space. Number 2 is potential energy. This is the energy that an object has due to its position relative to some reference point. So a book set on a shelf has potential energy. A ball at the top of a hill has potential energy. And in both cases, they have potential energy because it can be easily converted to kinetic energy, right? If the book falls off the bookshelf or the ball rolls down the hill, we're taking that potential energy and converting it to kinetic energy. Number 3 is chemical energy. This is the energy stored in chemical bonds and released through chemical reactions. The bomb example I mentioned earlier is not energy being created, but energy being transformed from chemical energy to thermal energy. Photosynthesis takes solar energy and converts it to chemical energy. So the energy from the sun is literally being stored in chemical bonds within plants, which is pretty sweet. Number 4 is electrical energy. This is the energy due to a separation of charges and flow of electrons, also called an electrical current. All your household appliances use electrical energy and convert it to some other type of energy. For example, your blender converts electrical energy to kinetic energy to spin the blades. Your toaster converts electrical energy to thermal energy to toast your bread. And finally, number 5, thermal energy. So this is the energy given off as heat. When you start a campfire, you're breaking chemical bonds in the wood and transferring the chemical energy of those bonds into thermal energy and fire. Right? Friction is another example. So when a ball is rolling across the ground, there's friction between the ball and the ground. This friction slows the ball down, but it's actually that kinetic energy being transferred into thermal energy, which is then dissipated into the ground. It's also why you can warm up your hands by rubbing them together, because you're taking kinetic energy, the movement of your hands, and converting it to thermal energy through the friction. So those are 5 types of energy that you should be familiar with. There are others, but those are the main ones. And all those examples illustrate the law of conservation of energy, which is that energy cannot be created or destroyed, only transferred or transformed. I hope this video helped you and you enjoyed seeing my face. If you're not a subscriber already, please do so now and check out my other videos. And if you have any additional questions, please throw them in the comments. I see and read every comment you guys make, and I appreciate all your questions and love to answer them. I'll catch you next time.